Cointreau. Cointreau is our delicious orange flavored friend. Cointreau can be substituted for or out with Grand Marnier. Grand Gala is the kind of off-brand version of that. Dry Curacao, which has, you might determine by the name, is a little bit more dry. And this Triple Sec is the kind of, you know, rail version of Cointreau. But if you want to taste something truly delicious, like the Cointreau is something that I believe a chocolatier would use to make their delicious chocolates taste of orange and booze. In fact, I'm pretty sure I've had a chocolate with a Cointreau center. Cointreau is delicious. And there are a number of drinks that you can make with Cointreau. Continuing on my rum, the lightening of my rum embargo that I've been on, Mai Tai. It's this or Grand Marnier, lime, orgeat, which is a syrup, an almond syrup, aged rum, dark rum, Cointreau. The Cosmo, you'll see that most often made with Triple Sec, but a Cosmo with Cointreau is decidedly better. Cosmo, of course, being vodka, lime juice, cranberry juice, and Cointreau. Brings just enough sweetness and enough orange, delicious orange flavor to the drink. The margarita, pulling out the Triple Sec, and anywhere you would see Triple Sec, you would put Cointreau. So a margarita made with Cointreau is a delicious margarita indeed. I would even say a delicious margarita would be just tequila and lime juice, maybe a little bit of sugar. That's a great margarita, but if you add the Cointreau, it's pretty delicious. McCartney on, I think it's his daughter's cooking show, Paul McCartney has a macarita that he makes, which is your tequila, some Cointreau, lime juice, and orange juice. So it's very orangey indeed, but also extremely delicious, especially with a salted rim, or how about a half salted rim, half salt, half sugar. Pretty amazing. A mimosa with a splash of Cointreau for a little extra orangey goodness in there. It won't kick up the ABV too much, so that's still like a chill drink to enjoy for brunch. You can enjoy that, but I wanted to talk about, or just focus rather for a second, on the sidecar, which is probably like the most, I would say, famous, like old school, I don't know. It's when I think of Cointreau, like a Cointreau drink, the sidecar is what I think of, and that's cognac, Cointreau, and lemon juice. Would file under classic cocktail, the Prohibition era cocktails that became so popular around the year 2009, or 8, or 7, or 5. Turn of the century, post 21st century cocktail revival. God, that makes me feel old. Actually, looking at my beard makes me feel old. I guess I'm just getting old. But I'm not as old as these drinks because they've been around for like 100 years. So, screw it. Who gives a shit? Cointreau. This you'll probably go through faster than, say, a bottle of absinthe. There's a lot more just kind of general uses. What if you had Godiva chocolate liqueur? We're coming up on the holidays, so you had, let's do like an ounce of the Godiva chocolate liqueur, and then maybe you would do like an ounce of vodka, and then maybe you do a half ounce of this. That would be like chocolate and orange. I mean, two great taste great together. There's also different ways that you could experiment cooking with Cointreau. This is one that I would bring into the kitchen. I mean, more for desserts, certainly. More for desserts, but any sort of confections that require some sort of glaze, a finish, an orange finish, Cointreau would be absolutely delicious there. So Cointreau, like I said, you'll go through this bottle of this a lot quicker because I think there's a lot more practical applications in that it's deliciously orange and sweet than, say, like absinthe, which is an acquired taste and licorice. and this one you don't tend to use a lot, like Luxardo. You use just a little bit and the flavor is kind of there. Like Cointreau, it's like, how orangey and delicious do you want it? It's kind of that simple. And I don't know. I don't want to put it above anything. I would say Cointreau would be my number one choice. followed by dry Curacao, and then Grand Marnier. But I love all three, so they're all a good choice. But yeah, try a bottle of Cointreau, or try cooking with it, try different drinks, try adding it to, like, if you think that, like, you're making a drink like the mimosa, as I said earlier, how about, like, if you were having, like, you know, grandma's over, she's having a screwdriver, like, make one for yourself, put a little Cointreau in there. Don't waste it on grandma, though. She's, like, so old and set in her ways, she probably just wouldn't even like it anyway, or wouldn't even notice it because her taste buds are shot. You know, grandma. Don't waste the booze on grandma. This has been Happy Hour, brought to you by Maine Spirits. You can learn more about Cointreau and many other liquors at mainspirits.com. You can download their app for your smartphone. That's a smart move. Why? What to buy, where to buy it, and what to do with it once you get it. You can follow them on Instagram at Maine_spirits. But as always, we implore you to drink deliciously and responsibly. Goodbye.